Good morning, friends, all dignitaries on the dais. I am very happy that we are meeting today when the global capacity being added this year is of the order of 100 gigawatts. And in that, India's contribution is of the order of 5.5 gigawatts this year, and let us see what happens further. And also, for some of us who started our journey when India was at 0 megawatt, 2006, to today when we are at 13,500-13,600 megawatts, it is a dream come true. When we started, as you all know, the price was somewhere around 15, 16, 17 crores per megawatt, which has dropped to now 3 crores, 3.5 crores. So, as I say that, you know, as mankind, we are undergoing an evolution, energy evolution. Old inefficient ways of the grid are giving way to the new efficient ways. And also, a thing to be marked is that new entrepreneurship, new companies have entered this field and are flourishing. In fact, if we talk of just the MNRE channel partners, young MNRE channel partners, they have all come. We'll talk about the big people a little later, but all these young people that we see, they are of the age group of 25 to 40. So this, in turn, they have generated employment. So this solar movement has generated employment. It is the only sector which has generated double-digit employment. So this is on the very bright side, and the price per kilowatt hour dropping is not only in India but all over the world. Having said that, we should also understand that whatever happened at that rumps, our 2.97, but we have to understand that, you know, it's not just 2.97, because it is there because of several enablers that were there, which is an ideal situation, does not exist everywhere. So when we talk of finance, we have to really understand some of those very important factors, like ease of land availability, connectivity, the client rating. For instance, they have all the client ratings, sovereign guarantee. If you take these things out, you cannot be at 2.97. So the reality is somewhere else that we should have. 2.44 is an aberration I don't even consider, as far as I am concerned. And friends, at the same time, let me mention to you that when I go to the ministry and express concern that, you know, this suicidal bids or low price bids, what is going to happen and things like that. I'll quote an important event. When Mr. Upendra Tripathi was the secretary, I went to him when the first time these prices started dropping. He only told me that, Mr. Mehta, have I ever refused if L1 was 5.5 or 6? You are talking of 5.05 or you are talking of 4.64. Your own people are doing this. So you have no case to say anything. You are a good friend, just have a cup of tea and go. Of course, then I had to explain to him that, sir, fine, I am also very happy that the price has dropped. It is your aim and our aim also as the National Solar Energy Federation of India, so that we want to make solar energy affordable. But if these projects, if they come up in time, if they really come up, then it is fine. Otherwise, what will suffer? The country's solar program will suffer. And other members, other players who did not have this chance, they will suffer. So, in other words, we have to make sure that those who have, my own members, those who have bid lower, they implement the project in time and in the right spirit. And one more thing before I end, because there are quite a few interesting speakers and lineup, is that to my mind, solar has the kind of future that for finance, Dhirubhai Ambani, when I was just 24, 25 years of age, he said these words when he came up with the new idea of that convertible debentures and non-convertible debentures and partially convertible debentures. He said to his people, I remember in Mumbai one evening, he told his people that, see, this is an ocean. You take out as much as you can based on your pump capacity. So solar energy sector, to my mind, is such, and renewable energy in general, is such that it is the future, it is the ocean from which you take out as per your pump capacity. And I wish you all success in so doing. Thank you very much.